Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to Point to Ponder. Now in this video we will study basically the semi-language coding form. Now if you remember, I had given you the 10 steps how to develop a semi-language program, and then I had written a sample program also, and then we assembled that program and debugged that program. So now, before I start with the series of, different assembly language programs to help the students to learn assembly language, I will basically, first of all, tell you that how we formally code, you can say, the assembly language program, or write the assembly language program. Obviously, it has to be written in a form. So if you can see on the screen, in the form, the first thing is that you write the name of the programmer, say for example programmer ABC, and then obviously you write which sheet or which is the number of sheet of this program, say for example sheet 1 of 3, that is the first sheet. Then we give the title of the program, that is the program title is, let's say, XYZ. And then it is the date. And then we write down the abstract that what this program is doing. For example, this program calculates the average temperature of twin cities, Islamabad and Rawalpindi. Okay. Then we write down the procedures. Now procedures we will study, you can say, I'll tell you that what all these procedures are, as we keep writing the program. For example, if you have to multiply two numbers, then instead of writing again and again the multiplication instructions, you develop a procedure, that is, you write down 3, 4, 5, 6 instructions of multiply procedure, and then you call whenever you require it. So if called, like you can say the multo, similarly the registers used, the register which you have used in all these programs which you have written, then the flags which are affected, only affected flag, as a result you have seen in the debugging program, and then the ports, if you have, let's say, written an input and output program and you have made use of the ports, then you can say that you mention that port 1, 2, 3, how many number of ports we have used. Then the memory, which have been allocated for the data, as well as you can say data segment, as well as the code segment, as we have seen in the previous assembly language program. And then obviously you give the format, and the format is that first of all it is the address, then the data segment or the code segment, then you have the labels, like you can say we had, let's say, the start table in our previous program. Then obviously you give the opcode, and then you can say the operand, and then finally the commands. Okay, so this is, you can say, assembly language coding form. Now the first program which I wish to write, assembly language program number 1, the task at hand is write an assembly language program based on microprocessor unit 8086 to calculate the average temperature of twin cities, Islamabad and Rawalpindi. Temperature of Islamabad is 27 degrees centigrade, suppose, and that of Rawalpindi is 31 degrees centigrade. Now, this is, you can say, the task which has been given to you, and then you write down the abstract. Now, as I told you before also, that you must write down the abstract, because when you are writing one hour program, it's okay, you will remember. But when, let's say, you have written about 10, 20, 30, 50 programs, then you will not know whenever you are consulting later on that what you have written. So abstract we write down, this program calculates the average temperature of Islamabad and Rawalpindi. Obviously, and then you know, as usual, we have already seen that we write down data segment, and segment, you know, it means start of the segment. So what we are saying is that we start a segment and give it the name data, and in that we first say that ISBT, that is temperature of Islamabad, dB defined by 1 BH, that is in the hexadecimal we have converted, you can say the decimal numbers. Now this is the temperature of Islamabad. What we have written is that defined byte, that we have reserved a byte in our data segment, you know, and this byte has been given the name ISBT, and in this location ISBT, you know, we have stored the Islamabad temperature, that is 1 BH. Next we see RWPT, that is Rawalpindi temperature. Similarly, Rawalpindi temperature defined by 1 FH, and in the comments we have written temperature of Rawalpindi. Then it is EVGT. So we have reserved an average temperature location. This is what we are going to, you know, calculate. So we have put the question mark because we don't know that, you know, what will be the average temperature. So reserve the location for the result. And next is the data ends. So that means the ends mean that the end of the segment. So data segment which we have started, you know, that is ending here. Next we start with the code segment, and as I had already told you that assume cs.code, that whenever you know the word code comes, then we write down in place of that CS, that is the abbreviation, and then comma DS colon data, that whenever, wherever in the program data appears, then replace it with DS. Okay, so then we start, and start is basically the label. We start the program and we say move AX comma data, that is we initialize the data segment, and move DS comma AX. Now you see on the right hand side is the source, on the left hand side is the destination, and as I had already told you that this is but a convention. We could have, you know, we could have written move DS comma data, okay, but that is not allowed. I mean in this 8086 you can say the in assembly language, you know, it is when we initialize the data segment, we first place the data, that is the address of the, you can say, data segment in AX, and then obviously the AX we transfer into the DS, that is data segment register. Okay, then we say move AL comma ISBT. So we load the Islamabad temperature in lower order byte of the AX, that is AL, and add RWPT. So we add in it the Rawalpindi temperature. Okay, then we clear the AH register by move AH comma 00H, that is the higher order byte of the AX, which is AH, that we are going to clear, and whenever you want to clear a register, we just load a 00 in it. ADC AH comma 00H. So obviously ADC mean add with carry. Place the carry in lower LSB of AH, that is the lower significant bit of the AH. Move BL comma 02H. So BL is another register, and its lower portion, BX is the register basically, and its, you know, the lower order byte is BL. So we are going to load, you can say, the divider in the BL register, and then we say div BL. Okay. Now divide AX. This means that divide AX by BL, place the quotient in AL and the remainder in AH. Like you can say, we had previously in our one of our program, we have written MUL, for example, the multiply instruction. Then obviously move AVGT comma AL. That is the copy the result which is there in AL, obviously that is the whatever is, you can say, the quotient was in AL, so that we are trying to move in the AVGT location of the you can say data segment or the memory. Okay, and here we write down code ends, obviously that is the end of the code segment, and then we give the instruction end start. Okay, that is, we are going to end our program and we jump this program back to start, because we are going to run this program in a loop again and again. Okay.